Hi guys, my name is Matti Sulanto, and in this video I'm gonna show you how to do focus stacking. Focus stacking is a way to increase the depth of field, especially in close-up and macro photography. And in this video I'm gonna show you how you can do focus stacking in your Lumix camera. And I'm also going to show you how you can do focus stacking in post in Photoshop or some other suitable application. In focus stacking, you take several pictures at different focusing distances, and then you combine those images, you put them on top of each other like layers, and you take the sharp part from each frame, and when you combine those you can get almost indefinite amount of depth of field, which can be very, very useful, especially in macro photography or in close-up photography where there's almost never enough depth of field, no matter how much you stop down. And when you combine several images, like focus stacking, you can use your lens's optimal aperture and you don't have to stop down all the way to f22, which is never the best aperture. And there are basically two ways to do focus stacking. You can do it in camera or in post. Let's first take a look at how you can do it in camera, and in this case, of course, a Lumix camera. This works pretty much the same way on every Lumix camera, whether it's the GX880 or the S1R or something in between. And this feature has been on Lumix cameras for a while, so even some of the older models should be able to do this. I shot this orange on a blue background for this video, and I used my Lumix G9 with the 12-60mm Leica lens in this case. But of course you can use any Lumix camera, pretty much any Lumix camera, like I already said. And why would you do focus stacking in camera? There are a couple of reasons. First of all, it's relatively easy. You don't have to kind of know much, and there's no need for any post-processing. Of course, the downsides are that you only get a JPEG file and you have very little control over the outcome. But let's do it and see how it turns out. I recommend you use a tripod here, but I suppose in some cases it's possible to do this also handheld, depending on the situation. First, you have to select the focus stacking mode on your camera. On the G9, it's the selector below the mode dial, but on some cameras you have a button for it. And then you select the image size, which would be 4K or 6K on those cameras that have that option. And bear in mind also that if your camera has a 4K crop in video mode, then the 4K crop also applies here. In my case, I used the 6K mode because the G9 has it, but like I said, 4K is just fine. It's just a little bit lower resolution. You can use any exposure mode, but I used manual mode because I get the most control over the exposure values, of course. My exposure values were f5.6 and 1/30th of a second and ISO 250. I chose the f5.6 because it's pretty much the sharpest aperture on this lens. And then you just hit the shutter and let the camera do the rest. It's pretty simple. It takes a couple of seconds, and the camera uses electronic shutter, so there's no shutter sound while the camera is making all the necessary exposures or the frames for the focus stacking. And when the camera has finished with the exposure, then switch over to the play mode and select the post focus play. And after that, select focus stacking, which is on the top right corner of the screen. And after that, you select auto merge or range merge. Auto merge means that the camera will decide which frames to combine, and with the range merge, you can touch the screen and select the focus points or focus area to merge into one frame. And here is the final result of my experiment with this orange. And as you can see, this seemingly simple setup, just the orange on the blue background, is not that simple. The end result is not perfect, even though I think you could publish this on Instagram, for example, and nobody might not notice anything, but it's not perfect. But this is just one picture, and in many cases the outcome is a lot better than this. But in this case, it's not perfect really, and because the camera is doing the job, you can't really fine-tune the end result anymore. But it's worth noting that all the stacked images are recorded on the card as a video file, so from that video file you can choose whatever frame you want if you just want one frame from there. And of course, I guess you could also choose all the frames and do the focus stacking in post in some, like in Photoshop or something. And now let's check out the other option. How to make focus stacking in post. In my case, I'm using Lightroom and Photoshop, but there are other applications that do the same thing. And why would you do this in post? One of the main upsides is that you get to shoot raw and you have more control over the outcome. And the downside is that there's more work, and it's also quite like a processor intensive task. It takes a lot of power. It requires a powerful computer, especially if you have a lot of frames. And you have to do the focus bracketing manually or let the camera do it. I'm not sure if every camera has focus bracketing built-in camera or focus bracketing feature, but Lumix cameras have that, and it's a pretty good feature. And it saves you a lot of time and effort, because you can just let the camera do all the focus bracketing and take all the necessary frames for you. I shot the exact same orange for this, but this time I shot raw and I selected the following settings for my focus bracketing. My step was +4 and the frame number was 26. And my aperture was exactly the same as in the previous picture, f5.6. It's hard to say any optimal settings for the bracketing, because it depends on your focal length, your shooting distance, and also the subject. So I suggest you experiment a little bit, and after a few experiments you get the hang of it, and then you can optimize the frames you really need for your stacking. It doesn't make any sense to shoot way too many frames, because it's just unnecessary work for your computer to stack them all. And after I shot the picture, I imported the frames in Lightroom. And in Lightroom, I checked one more time that my focusing was correct and the bracketing covered the whole orange. And then I processed one file to my liking, and then I copied the processing settings to all the bracketed frames. And then I selected all the files and selected open as layers in Photoshop. And then it takes a while until all the frames are loaded into Photoshop. And in Photoshop, in the edit menu, I chose auto merge layers. This can take some time depending on the number of files you have and also what kind of computer you have. And here's the final picture. And as you can see, even Photoshop had some hard time with this one. There are some blurry areas in the picture that look pretty weird. And also the lower part where the background meets the subject looks kind of funny. And after I edited some layers in the stack, the picture looks like this, and now it's already quite good. It's not still perfect, but it looks pretty nice. And here's the same picture shot at f22. And if we compare it to the stacked image shot at f5.6, we can see that the stacked image looks a lot sharper, and we can also see that there's not enough depth of field even at f22. So the stacking would be the only option to get enough depth of field in this case. However, if I publish either of these pictures, for example, on Instagram, I think they would be equally good or bad. Because of the nature of Instagram, how quickly people browse through the pictures and the small image size. So I think it's really worth considering carefully when the extra effort of stacking pictures is really worth it. Anyway, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one.